Hello and welcome to this honest review of Vid Toon, and this will be excruciatingly honest. So it's a very good price, it's $37, and no doubt you might be able to get it cheaper still, and it's used to make animated explainer videos or animated videos. But is it any good? Well, I'm going to talk about that in this video. So before we go into the review, I just want to show you something I knocked up using this software. It's just a 10 second little video for a made up company called Ninja Travel, but I just want to show you what's possible with the software to be as fair as I can.
Feeling tired and need a vacation? Get away with Ninja Travel this summer.
So first of all, when you purchase it, you will download a zip file. It's quite a big zip file. It's about 670 megabytes, but you download that. And then when you decompress it, like I've done here, you can pretty much run it straight away. You notice you've got Unity stuff. Well, it's a Unity application, so you don't need to install it. You just run it straight away as it is. So I click on Vid Toon, or double click on Vid Toon, and it starts to load. So here it is, and we can change the screen resolution. I'm going to go for the highest here. I've never changed the graphics quality. I'll leave it at ultra, and I'm going to put it on here because I'm using two monitors at the moment. So I'm going to click play. So here we see Vid Toon loading. So you need to put in your email address that you purchased it with. Done. You can create or load a new project. So I'm going to create a project called demo. And here we are. We've got our timeline. We've got our sort of assets. And we just pull them in. It's very simple. So we've got our three layers here. And this is the problem with this application. Can be as good as you want, but if you've only got three layers, you are really, really limited. So we're going to add a background, and we just drag it in and we put it on this timeline. And it's annoying that it always appears small. So you drag on this red icon to make it bigger. So I want it to be the full size. So I'm going to put it up there and I'm going to drag this down. It's just a very official government looking background. So I can move this along, and again, I can drag it out to the full 10 seconds. I can add more time here, and I can take it away here, and I can play here. I can pause, stop, etc. Stopping it puts it back to the beginning. So now I probably want a character, and there's loads of characters. It's quite a lot here. Loads of characters, ninjas, boxers. They're alphabetical, which is useful. You can search for them. And it doesn't just search by the first part, it searches for bits within the string, which is useful. One of my criticisms of these types of software is it's very difficult to search for things, but you can search for things. So loads that I can scroll through. You know, you do get lots and lots of characters. Let's have a senior businessman. He can be a senator. So let's put him here. And he's already doing an action. So I'm going to put him down here. He seems to be dancing about. I can make him bigger or smaller here. And again, I can move him out. If I play this, we just see he's moving. He's doing his thing. And he's disappeared because I haven't dragged this out. So I'm going to drag it out to here. Let's stop it. And there we are. If I want to change his behavior, I click on him or click on the timeline. I go up here to settings and I can change his start time duration. I can flip him horizontally. So yep, he's facing the other way. Let's take that off. And I can change his behavior. And I got quite a lot of behaviors here. Let's have him flying with balloons. I can put him on a loop. I can set when he appears and disappears. And I can do a moving from A to B, and I can duplicate. I don't really know what duplicate does. Duplicate doesn't really make much sense to me. So this would be a really boring animation. So I'm going to set him from an A to B. So I'm going to click on him here. And we're going to do some A to B moves. So I need to check this for A to B. So I move this to where I want it to be. So I'm going to move it here. And now let's play it. So he moves from A to B. Now notice he seems to be dropping down for some reason. So let's select him again. Now, it's really odd because the flag here, even if I have the bottom part of the flag as the lowest part, he does seem to be moving off screen. So I'm going to put him all the way up here and I'm going to put him there. Let's see what happens now. So that's a bit rubbish, isn't it? So he doesn't actually go to where you want him to go. He carries on his path that he was on before. So it's almost like we need to get rid of this move A to B, take it off, try again. Let's try move A to B. It's where it was before. So what we need to do is, I've never had to do this before, we have to sort of clear it and start it again. And then I'm going to add in a few more seconds, and I'm just going to extend this. I have to scroll along here. Okay, so I have, there doesn't seem to be any control bar here. This would be my duplicated one, so I'm going to delete that. So I seem to have some duplicated one that I don't want, so I can sort of move along this way. Right, so I need to go all the way to here to get rid of it. Now let's try that again. Stop. Start. So that's what I'd expect to happen. I put the flag there at 10, and of course he's going to disappear. So I'll just make him go along here. Just make it so it's even with the background. He should stop and just hang about for a second or two. No, he just goes off. So the animation does look good. It's a bit of a hassle to put together. It's not very intuitive at all. But here, and me using it for the second or third time, I'm finding new things out all the time because it's so unintuitive. But one background, one character, it doesn't really make an animation, so we might want to add another one in. Got another character, but he disappears. So I'm going to select the character, I'm going to make him go for the same amount of time. Let's see what happens. So he's there, he's permanent. Let's do some animating of him. Let's have a zoom in. He zooms in. And let's make him for sale. So he pops up, he's for sale. The other man floats away. We go off the page. That's that. I'm going to export. Just going to save as output one. Okay, so it's playing on the full screen and it's doing that as it exports. And you know, it looks really good. It looks like a really good video. Still seems to be going for some reason. I'm not sure where the video ends and it stopped. Let's see if that output has worked. Here we go, output one. Oh, we've got a file now. Saved as an MP4. So that looks really good. That looks like a really good animation. It's low file size. It's exported at 720. There doesn't seem to be any options to export at a higher resolution. We can add music in. I don't know what music one is. No idea what that was because I've got my mic plugged in so I can't hear it. But again, or we can pull it down. That doesn't seem to have worked. Ah, there we are. We can do some text-to-speech recording, so we can, if I click here, oh, it doesn't seem to work. Nope, that doesn't work. If I click here, I can add some text. Your text goes here. This is so unintuitive. Right, I'm going to have to go into settings, aren't I? Right. Test text. Test text. Let's make it bigger. Oh, can't seem to make it bigger. Let's put it up there. Let's watch this with the music. So you can't really change backgrounds. Have to swap them out. So let's swap them out like this. See what happens here. Ah, okay. It's a very, very difficult to use and very unintuitive piece of software. It will do the job. It will get it done. You really need a lot of patience for this. I mean, like I say, you've got lots of characters, gallery. You can clearly import your own images if you want. You've got loads of characters. It has promise, but it just seems a little frustrating and unintuitive. And yeah, we've got loads of backgrounds as well. To put together something that's not just a few seconds would be really difficult, I think. Really difficult. So that's my review. Cheap, can do the job, but no doubt it's going to leave you frustrated. Thank you.